I spent the month of August on the road, unfortunately not in the Acty. In my absence, Dave and Jason kept working on it and made lots of progress. They began by disassembling our motor in order to clean it. The motor we got was in pretty rough shape, having been through an entire previous life inside a forklift. It's kind of a crucial component, so we wanted to make sure everything in it was in the best shape it could be. I watched from afar as they showed me their progress. Since I was away, and I was thrilled, I guess you could say I was separately excited afield.
Today's project is taking apart the motor, getting it cleaned up, and painting it.
Not sure how to feel about the fact that I left and they immediately appear more competent.
In the process of taking out this very long screw, I managed to brace the drill between the side of the truck and the motor frame.
Well, maybe I'm worried about nothing.
These are the brushes. They have springs, and they have tension against the commutator here. They're supposed to kind of spring. When we got it out, this one was all the way back.
Okay, that's all.
Hey, another time lapse. I don't have anything new to say about the motor, so now might be a good time to tell you a fun fact about Acties. They made a variant called the Attack, which is for use on farms, and a variant called the Dump, which is a little baby dump truck. They also made a combination, which they called, and this is real, the Attack Dump.
Yeah, we couldn't get this flange part off. We think it might be welded onto the shaft, which is going to complicate things a little bit. Next thing is figure out how we can get those coils out of that housing and probably paint that. Yeah, we'll assess what needs replaced in here, what we can repair, and then we'll put it all back together.
Okay, during this time lapse, how about some other bits we didn't have room for in previous videos? We are pro recycling, so why not recycle content? How about when we discovered that the Acty only had one speaker? We should have recommended that the driver lean to the left while driving so they could hear the radio better. There was also a time we found a product labeled orifice tubes, which had a very suspect O on the label. I don't know, maybe these bits should have stayed in the recycle bin.
Well, we're hoping the warranty hasn't expired. Insane amount of corrosion on this wire, and when we were taking it out, it just snapped, which I'm not gonna blame us because it looks like it was definitely ready to go.
With a piece having come out of our motor, it seemed important to test continuity to make sure nothing else had been broken.
So we're pretty sure that these magnets here are not coming out. We're just gonna have to work around the fact that they're in there. And there's all kinds of debris inside. Most of it has been removed at this point. Now we're gonna work on cleaning things up.
Raise your right hand if this hurts. Come back in 6 months for another cleaning.
We finished grinding, and now we're just gonna do some sanding to get rid of some of the more persistent rust.
The wire wheel wasn't enough. Switched to the angle grinder here. Got most of that pitted rust off. Getting ready for painting now. So now that the rust is all off, got a good surface to prime and paint this, if the weather cooperates today, which so far it hasn't. We are ready for prime time.
So now we've got the brush housing made of aluminum, unlike the rest of it. We're just getting the paint off that and sanding it so we can repaint. This is probably the most interesting part of the project that we've done yet. I could just mask all day. La Croix sparkling water. If you're watching, we are eager for a sponsorship. You don't want us to blur out these cans every time they're in a shot.
We were thinking about doing a time lapse on the drying primer here, just for you, the viewer. 8 hours of relaxing paint drying.
Very well-practiced motion.
Yeah, if I get behind the cardboard, you can't see what I'm doing.
Getting ready to paint the last piece of the motor housing here. Flange wouldn't come off of the shaft. Kind of had to make do, obviously masked off. Armature parts and bits that you don't want rust or dust or paint on. I'm gonna have to mask off all these holes too, just so I don't get paint in the threads.
The goal for today is to put this motor back together, and who knows what nightmares we will encounter in this process. Ring terminals here are a little bit bigger than the one that was originally on there, so I'm gonna try to make it work. Not too optimistic.
This is the old one, and the crimp is appropriately sized for this tiny wire, and this one that's for a much bigger wire.
I'm very annoyed that the videos that Dave and Jason took while I was gone looked more competent than the ones they did while I was here, and it's because they did a time lapse, so I'm now insisting that we do a time lapse.
Yeah, it's definitely just the time lapse thing. Yeah, we look competent in time lapse, but you only look cool in slow-mo.
When I was getting the other one of these guys in here, I was like, how'd you do this without breaking it? And they said, we broke it.
This is the one where everything could go wrong.
I believe in you.
That makes one of us.
So we're playing, how many people does it take to screw in a bolt? So
there's the original terminal that we didn't break, and here's the one that we did break, and that we just fixed, and it was a little bit difficult to get in place, but I think we got it.
We broke the other one.
This was weak and flimsy and corroded as hell before we got anywhere near it, and frankly it's probably good that we aren't relying on it. We have fixed now both of these contacts. They aren't pretty, but you know, they weren't pretty when we started either, and these contacts that we built are actually cleaner, and we tested for continuity. They've got continuity. We did not break the SEPX field. I mean, we did break the SEPX field, but we fixed the SEPX field. Here's another view of our fixed terminals.
Putting it back together.
Nobody actually knows how ratchets work. There's a tiny wizard who lives in here, and that's actually him grumbling that you hear when you twist it.
We're in our 30s.
This is my other favorite thing about this beautiful paint job that Jason gave us. He ran out of black paint, and so it's got tuxedo paint job.
Look into the eye of God.
Uninstalling this piece of tape now. Flange.
True.
So we're talking about how to slide it in, and we're also talking about how to put our motor back together.
Well,
Jason's fisting something again.
Yeah,
so.
Which happens. So the brushes are in springs, mm-hmm. which usually hold them up against this thing. But the problem is now that the hole is much smaller than the thing that's supposed to go into.
Relatable problem. To get this into this, we have to get the brushes out of the way. So we're pulling them out of the way with string. This is the back of the brushes. You can see these big, thick cables are replacements. There was originally a much thinner cable here, which someone has snipped off. Somebody wanted this to carry a lot more current, and that lines up with what the guy in Georgia told us. It had been previously owned by somebody who had made modifications. We're on plan C or D at this point, where we're trying to use duct tape. We don't want to get tape on the brushes themselves, so we've put like a little strip of duct tape down the middle of the tape. So the tape only gets tape on the tape. This is going to get lined up over the brushes. The brush shouldn't have gunk on it. It's got to make contact with the metal on the commutator and carry a current. Certainly don't want to get gunk on it. That would get burned off. Duct tape diaper. We got it in. The duct tape method worked.
I didn't get video because there's only two of us today. You're going to have to take my word for it.
And now we are in the process of bolting everything back together. Slightly concerning, we do have some mystery bolts, but you know what they say, if you put something back together and you have parts left over, you've just made that thing more efficient. It's back together. There's a few things that are wrong. When we got this, these were actually aligned because somebody had previously rotated this an inch that way so that they can bridge these with a copper thingy that they built. The other problem is that it's not turning. Now, when we turn it manually, it does turn. And we've tested continuity on a bunch of things, so we're not totally sure what's up, but we're gonna call it a night here and figure it out later.
Yesterday we spent a lot of time trying to figure out how to get these brushes out of the way. We had a pretty complicated solution with duct tape. It took a long time. And today I figured out that really all you need to do is take these springs and just kind of move them out of the way, and then you can pull the brush the whole way out. So I went around and did that because we needed to take this part off again, so we're learning a little bit. We corrected the problem we had from yesterday. These terminals here, we originally had them aligned so that A1 terminal kind of lined up with this S2 terminal. And then we figured out that that wasn't how it was originally done. We needed to put this bridge bar back in, unbolt it, and use these bolt holes instead, which kind of turns this whole thing a few degrees and lines up our S1 and A1 terminals. So then we can put this bridge bar on.
We just tested this one to see if it was already charged, since we can't charge it ourselves until we get our battery management system. And each one's 3.2 volts, and it's giving us 3.2 volts, so it's charged.
We're gonna wire four of these batteries in series, and then see if we can power our motor with them. Don't touch those.
Let those two touch.
Yep.
12 volts. All right.
I'm getting bored. What if we just power this little cart? Awesome.
We're seeing if our separately excited field that we repaired actually does anything when we spin the motor. Yep, that does something. Yeah, I think it's a multi-motor. Awesome.
We've learned so much about cars and electronics just over the course of these months. I go back and look at the fireworks pic I put behind us successfully soldering an AM transmitter together, and I'm like, wow, that was this spring. It's hard for me to describe how satisfying it is to take something apart, put it back together again, and have it work better. Next time, we'll resume our attempts to overhaul the cab to be more energy efficient. We also finally received the controller, so there will be a video coming out about that soon, too. Also, we made a little online store where you can buy stickers that proclaim your love of mini trucks. The links to that and to our GoFundMe are in the description.
Alright, the motor is installed. We have finished our conversion.
Sometimes we say engine when we mean motor. We've edited those out fairly seamlessly, I think. See if you can spot them. Honestly, this is just something we're doing because we know we'll get comments if we call the motor an engine. So, just FYI, technically speaking, a motor is a type of engine.